game two. Golden State at home, 11.5, 227 the total. I saw the Pelicans 120-1 to come back and win this series. How about that? So they are trying for their 15th straight home win in the playoffs, which would tie an NBA record. They figured to get it tonight, and they blew them out in game four. That was the Golden State team we all know and love, 118-92, and the return of the death lineup as Kerr put them back in the starting lineup. The death lineup was sensational. They did, Durant had 38 points. The defense played well. And here they are, though. They've struggled in this spot. 4-14 ATS in their last 18 games following a straight-up win. Pelicans also got the money in Golden State game two.
Yeah, I mean, look, you talk about that death lineup with Iguodala along with the All-Stars, Curry, Thompson, Durant, and Green. He put that lineup in to open the game, and lo and behold, a 17-4 opening run. And it was ball game right there. So we give Kerr credit for making adjustments. Let's also give Golden State credit for the strength of this home court. Betting against the Warriors at home in the postseason, not necessarily an easy thing to do. They've won 14 consecutive playoff games right here on this floor. That's one shy of the NBA record. The Bulls hold that record. They won 15 straight at home in 1990 and 1991, those two postseasons. So it's a strong home court. It's a lineup that is now healthy and clicking on all cylinders. But as you mentioned, it's a Warriors team that has not been particularly good in this role this year. 4-14 the last 18 following a win. Meanwhile, the Pelicans, this has absolutely been their role. 11-2 against the spread their last 13 overall. They've been an undervalued commodity since day one of the postseason. 13-4 against the spread their last 17 on the highway. Worth noting, that 13-4 mark, two of the losses came by a half point. It could very easily be a 15-2 point spread mark for the Pelicans on the highway. They've been good, consistent moneymakers in this road dog role.
All right, what happens with the Pelicans now? With the bench been outscored 134-95 in the four games, so they burned the starting lineup. Davis, 39 minutes. Holiday, 38 minutes, leading the series in minutes played. Gentry called off a workout on Monday in Oakland. Quote, we do have guys that are playing heavy minutes. Really, all the starters are playing really heavy minutes. I thought it would be a good idea to let their minds rest, let their bodies rest. Well, they're also, what is it now, like 27-3 the last 30 times they met, whatever it is, straight up. What do you think? Can you make a, you're going to make a case for the dog, and we could we see the third straight under?
You know, I wouldn't be laying with Golden State here. I do think that of the two double-digit dogs tonight, you asked me which team's more likely to show and fight to the finish. I'll say New Orleans, simply because, A, they're healthier, and B, they're better. you know, the Jazz, without being healthy, you can't expect a whole lot. Whereas New Orleans, they're healthy, and they're coming off a bad game. We've seen them do very, very well in this role. That being said, Golden State's been dynamite at closing teams out when they had the opportunities. And let's put it this way. They've held the home court advantage in every single playoff series that they've been in since Steve Kerr took over as head coach 2014-2015. And they've won game five, always at home, in eight of the last nine times the series has reached a game five. The only loss that they've suffered in this role came game five against the Cavs back in 2016. We all remember that game. That was a game that Draymond Green was suspended and allowed Cleveland to get the momentum and end up winning a title because of it. But certainly it's a Warriors team that has taken care of business, a Warriors team that's done it on the defensive end in particular. You know what, they've won every game and they hold an opponent under 100 points. But you talked about the rest for New Orleans. I thought it was an interesting decision from Gentry to give the team the day off yesterday. Say, hey, get your heads right. Get your bodies right. They've done well with extra rest here in the postseason. They have not done well when they've been a little bit fatigued. In theory, tonight, they should be more rested than they were in the ugly loss over the weekend in game number four. Like the show? Help us keep the lights on. Please make sure to comment, share, and subscribe to all the Sportsbook Review videos. Thanks so much. Best of luck. Enjoy the game.